been talking about an intimate conversation. I wanna see if I can make you reach things unobtainable when I peek into your nature. And I promise you my goals will exceed any physical pleasure. I wanna give you what's better than better. The better my effort, the wetter her treasure. The more these mere moments seem like heavens or temporary forevers. Shawty, get it together. Dice pie now. May your love come now, so my mind might have you. You design my imagination. Let me redefine four plays, and you need five. And tell me, Shawty, you got it, baby. If it's not it, baby.
Hey YouTube, it's your girl, I Am Nubian with I Am Nubian Customs, and today we're just going to be doing a little bit of self-care routines, starting off with a body scrub for after we do all of our shaving and everything, with some organic sugar. And the products in this video is sponsored as well. I already put a little bit in the bowl. And sorry if the lighting on this video is messed up, but it is what it is. So we're going to about cover the bottom of the bowl in a nice layer. I would prefer to use coconut oil because coconut oil is antifungal, bacterial, and all that other good stuff. But instead, we're going to be using castor oil because this is what I had on hand. Some vitamin E oil and some sesame seed oil. All of these products are organic and hexane free. And starting off with the castor oil, that's for the body scrub. Gonna add that to the sugar. You don't need a lot because we're gonna be using other oils. You don't want it too greasy. And a little bit of sesame. So at this point, all your sugar should be pretty much coated really good. Some other oils that you could probably use, I'm going to add some black seed oil to this as well. And if you have hemp oil, you could also use hemp oil. But I'm probably going to put this in my facial. If you do have that, remember to keep it in your refrigerator because it will go bad. And it'll be a waste to get one. And it ain't cheap. So you'll be wasting about good $20 for nothing. This is the one I had the dropper in it. It's not a lot in there because I have bees against my mouth. Get a syringe full of that. And this is going to help detox everything, purify everything. And all of this stuff is to reverse dark spots and detox at the same time, pretty much. And leave your skin feeling real, real smooth and everything. Also in this, because this is for dark spots, we're going to be using some tumeric. A little bit of this goes a long way because it does smell and it does stain. So if you are going to be using this, make sure that you are all the way naked. Or have on clothes that you do not care about. And I put like bare anywhere. I know the lighting sucks. Sorry. And last but not least, I have two different tea tree oils. This is also antifungal as well. I have a facial one and I just have a 100% pure one. This is normally used to dilute in water, any type of oil or whatever else you're going to use. So, with that being said, I don't want it too potent and burn myself because I am about to shave. So, I'm just going to use the facial one. Because this one is already diluted how it needs to be. And let's put three squirts of that. Then I already washed off my lemon. And this is what you're going to be using to scrub your actual skin with. But I'm going to cut half and save half for my yummy steam. And the other half, I'm going to save for my scrubber and squirt the juice into the actual scrub. So I'm going to cut it in half. I'm going to use the bigger side for the scrub. And the smaller side for the steam. And all you got to do is just have your separate one and take those seeds out. Another natural bleaching property that you could add to this is some baking soda as well, which I'm going to stir this up first and then further see how much of that I want to add. And remember to leave a little bit of juice in there, and it's big enough for you to hold and maneuver. If any seeds fall out, just pick them out with your hand before you start stirring. And being that I am going to be working with bentonite clay a little bit, I already have a plastic utensil. And after you start it, you can just get some plastic wrap and let it set while you're doing the rest of your beauty routine. And it should have like applesauce like consistency. If it's too runny, just add more sugar and or baking soda. If y'all see any of my other videos, I love baking soda. Put baking soda on everything. And this will also help with pH and everything else. We have this alkaline, and it'll turn a little bit foamy because it's reacting to the acid. So don't let that alarm you. Just add a little bit more sugar. Set that to the side. A little bit like that. Okay. I'm gonna set our lemons to the side. Alright, moving on to our facial part of the pamper routine. So I'm gonna put this on the side. Make sure your utensil is going to stir up. Get some clay. You just want to do a thin layer at the bottom, like how you did for the other portion. Maybe I should have left it in the slightest shift of turmeric. This shit is all out, you guys. some vinegar up here, but I don't want to do the vinegar because the stuff is so loud and it's going to stink. I don't think I want all that. So, we're just going to substitute that with some shampoo. And squeeze a little bit more of that one. And this will act as the acid. A little vitamin E. And castor. If you want to do the apple cider vinegar, you can go ahead and do that. I'm just choosing not to do that. I'm not nude for that. If it's not enough, like how this is, all you gotta do is just add a little bit more oil. So I'm gonna add a little bit more castor oil. Other things you could use in this, you could use raw honey as well, before or after. And if you see my other facial that I did, I had used the chia and hemp flaxseed mixture. And added it to it for my liquid as well. So there's different variations of this that you can do. And this is literally enough just for your face. And this is for under the arms and thigh and leg area. Everything is edible, but I wouldn't. And now that we have that prepped, go ahead with the rest of our routine. I'll see you in the bathroom. Ciao. Okay, y'all. So now I'm back. I'm in the bathroom. And I just got everything prepped up for this facial. And then I have my scrub and stuff after I shave and everything over there. This is the actual facial again. So it should be real thick. Almost like... not like Play-Doh, but a little stiff, not runny, if that makes sense. What you're going to do is you're going to put that all over your face. You can do this with your hands, just make sure your hands are washed really good. Or if you want to use the knife or spoon or whatever you're using, you can use that as well. This mask isn't like the other mask that I had did that was real runny. It's more fine. I do have a spin brush, but I will be going in with a hand scrubber. This is the one I usually have in the shower with me when I wash my face on a daily. Then after I use the lemon on my underarms and in between my legs, I will go in with this one because you want to make sure that these are separate and I got different colors so I wouldn't get confused. Y'all know I'm adamant about a white towel, so... finish rinsing off the rest of your face. Yeah, my towel's a little bit beat up because I to use activated charcoal soap and stuff like that. So, yeah. And the turmeric and stuff stains them, but it's still white. So it doesn't matter. So after we do all of that, for my face and my lady parts, I will be going in with that homemade serum that I had made. It has natural herbs and oils in there. But before we do that part, we will be washing our body and stuff with some oatmeal Yarly soap. And I went and got the pure castor peppermint soap. This stuff is a pretty penny, but it is so worth it. It means that my eczema and everything is flaring up. And I'm back on my supplements and everything. I just want a soap that's not going to irritate down there. So, only way to go is 100% pure soap. And this is the brand of razors that I will be using, because if I use any other kind, it causes hella razor bumps and stuff like that. So these cost a little bit more, but hey, it is what it is. Boom, boom. Alright, so getting into the facial. As you see, like I said, it stains. That's why I have on something black. Because it's even the stainless. Just make sure your hair is pulled back and out the way. Make sure it doesn't get on your hair, because the turmeric does have a light smell to it. Not nothing super crazy, but just a light smell. And it's going to be more oily than anything. I feel it working, though. The other one I had did, it was more like, it sticks to your face. This one is more oil-based, so it's like going on kind of weird. Are we going to make it work? It smells real good, too. And this is just going to hydrate your skin. Yeah, all down in there. I'm doing this right over the bathroom sink, so it's going to be an easy cleanup. You have rugs or anything that's going to stain, I'm going to remove them, because they will be stained. And again, sorry for this lighting, but this is the best I could do to bring all y'all videos right now. So you just want to massage it until it just rubs out your hand. And you'll just let this set on your face while you're doing the rest of your routine, like shaving and stuff like that. If it gets to a point where it's intolerable, like your body is reacting to it or something, because everybody's body is a little bit different. And I really don't measure anything. I just put stuff in there. You can go ahead and just rinse it off. Kind of, especially if you're new to using any of this type of stuff. Because I remember the first time I used bentonite clay. Oh my God, it opened up my pineal gland so much. It's not even funny. And just make sure you're getting up under your eye and not too close to where it's gonna burn. Especially if you have the apple cider vinegar in there, you really want to make sure to be careful about by your eyes. And I'm starting to feel the lemon, like the acid from the lemon. And you want to go in circles. And all of this is helping your collagen rebuild. It's bringing blood flow to the surface. Shedding off all that old skin. Y'all just rejuvenate. So when I'm done, all I gotta do is just turn on the sink and all of this will just rinse down. Or I can pick up whatever with a towel and throw it in the trash and then rinse out the rest. Because it does have oils in there. I don't want nothing clogging up the sink. You feel me? So you just pulled your hair like that. You have lashes. Be careful. I can feel my lash doing this, but it's nothing getting on it. So just make sure that you're paying attention. Massage your temples. Detox deep down in there. You could also let this set overnight to make it more potent, or, you know, to the side until like you get back and want to do it. Because the longer it sits, the more potent it is. I don't know, I'd be all up in y'all, girl, but what's the massage your pineal. These folks is going crazy about this virus, y'all. I just don't understand. And I'm over here talking about something. A facial. Another thing I had got you guys today, I got the nail kit, the kiss nail kit. I really want to try that out, but I was like, let me do my facial stuff first so it doesn't stain the nails. So I tried to go to the hair store. The hair store was closed. I knew I should just got all that braiding hair when I had the chance, but you know what? It is what it is. And I'm just going back through, using up the extras to get any spots that I think I'm gonna miss. Rub on your eyebrows, and this will help with any like alopecia in your eyebrows and stuff as well. Because I know when I was younger, I used to try to, you know, follow trends and stuff. Knowing damn well I need to, because I had pretty good eyebrows, and the lady ended up permanently fucking my eyebrows. Now they're like super uneven. That's why I draw up in the first place. So that castor oil will help stimulate that follicle. And that bentonite clay getting down in there, you know, all that dirt and clump. So now that I have all of that, I'm just going to take a little bit of that scrub we had with the sugar in it. I'm going to place that right on top. It's a scrub art, right? And I'm not really too worried about my lid. We're just gonna go in with the towel and get real close to that. Make sure we're not messing up our lash, as you know. And speaking of lashes, I've been doing real good with this pair of lashes. I've had this pair of lashes for like 2-3 weeks now. Going on my 3rd week. And I still have 2 more in the pack, but I don't really don't want to open them unless I'm not going to be doing something. Especially if this hair store can be closed. Because when I went to like Walgreens and stuff, them option for lashes up there was so ugly. At this point, you should start feeling your face getting warm. I'm trying to feel my eyes get warm. Remember, it's different properties in both feet. It's pretty much the same, but I think it's that tea tree oil. Then if you want to, you can dip back in the other part of your facial. I'm going to put some more of that on here. So I was saying he either get a towel and pick that up and throw it in the trash and then rinse that out because it has oil in there. You don't want to clog up your sink. And just make sure you have bleach or whatever, and that yellow will come right out. But for your clothes, honey, if you got that turmeric on your clothes, this is not coming up. You might as well DIY it. I feel like this is good. My skin looks fully coated. Everything is warm. I got close to the hairline, but I don't want to get too close. Because I don't want that turmeric smelling in. So, I'm just going to go ahead and shave and let this sit on my face. And then I'm going to come back and rinse it off. And when I rinse it off, I will be using this soap. When I shave, I'm going to lather up with this to shave with. And then, to wash off, like, into my legs and stuff. Like I said, my eczema and everything has been flaring up a little bit. So, we just want to make sure our pH balance and everything is good. We're starting that, what was that medication called? Metformin. And my Vitex. And I'm still taking that rainbow light as well. Yeah, I'm just gonna go in with that after. And boom. Also, if you do have the activated black charcoal soap, you can go ahead and use that as well. It's still from the Yardley's brand. I'm sorry, y'all, she's brand. It's still from the Yardley brand. Or if you can find any other type of brand that says activated charcoal soap, that's good as well too. Just know that if you do use this in your hygienic parts, this is detoxing you. So the next couple days afterwards, you might perspirate different, or your pH and hygiene odor might be a little bit different. I'm not saying different in a bad way. It's just the fact that it's detoxing, it's changing stuff in your body. So the smell that you're probably used to or scent that you're used to having, you're not going to have. Depending on how the detoxification goes for you. Especially like in the summer months, because you're going to be sweating and stuff anyways. It really does kind of change up the way you smell and stuff. But not really, really bad. Out of doing all of this stuff with detox and stuff using natural products, the worst thing that smell came from was taking that Serapeptis. I ain't even gonna lie. Still to this day, I'm still stuck on that shit. I never knew. I'm gonna lie. That detoxing could smell so weird. Which now, if I'll take it, it doesn't smell like that. But that first time I took it, you know, it's kind of wasn't expecting that. Especially because I tried to drink some liquor too or something. I think the first couple of days I did it. And yeah. That's just saving my penis a lot. Okay, so I'm going to put it in this. And I'll be back tomorrow. Also, when you're prepping water for your shaving stuff, you want to make sure the water is high as possible that you can stand it. I'm not ready with an actual shower because it is textural. I'll just say it's better than an actual shower. So you want to fill this up most of the way. And it also saves on water, like your water bill too. It's really hot to wrap and sand it. This is the green rub alcohol. You can also use witch hazel if you have that. And I had washed out the sink with some Clorox, which again, none of these products are sponsored. These are the products that I use. Again, so. And then what you're going to do is take one of your razors and you're going to dip it into the water so that it gets sterilized. This is what it looks like. Just dip that in there like that to sterilize it. And set that there. Set these out the way. And get it popping. Alright, and also when I lather, I just turn on the water a little bit. That's why I only fill it up halfway. That way I can wipe off a little bit because, you know, soap will make you itchy or whatever. And then go to the other leg and just rub it on the towel so that way all my water doesn't get too soapy. So, yeah. And then we get in the tub. Go ahead with this one. If that was any type of confusion there. I'm just telling people I can't just wash it once if I have to use a body wash. I have to use a bar soap. So if not, if I just use one, it's gonna feel weird. But okay, y'all. So I just finally got done shaving and everything. I didn't moisturize yet. Yeah, but the moisturizer that I will be using, it's like these body oils that I have for a little while. I went to go buy the coconut oil today and didn't buy in the one store. I thought when I went to the other store, I was going to have what I wanted, but they didn't. So I'm going to do that tomorrow, but I'm going to lotion up my whole body with this. And I'm putting this on my inner thighs and stuff and on my face only. And again, we're washing it. I thought this was the peppermint soap. But this is the lavender and hemp one. So, yeah. And I didn't do it in the shower because I just forgot. I ended up using my towel to wipe my legs. So, what you want to do is you fill up the water with alcohol. You shave your bikini line and all that stuff first. Let that water out. Put the scrub on, all of that. And then you go and do one leg after you fill up some fresh water. And then do the other leg. Let that water out. And then do some more water, just let the water run to do your underarms or whatnot. And then that way, after you shave each part, the scrub can sit on there. And then I got in the shower and washed up with my pink hand and this soap and stole my soap. So I'm gonna go in and scrub with this. And I didn't have any more white towels, so I had to get the green one. And this water might be loud, so if you have one, I'm sorry. I forgot to say it last time. I keep wiping my face. Forgetting my questions on here. Okay, y'all. So, this is what it looks like. And just keep going in circles. I see it. You can get your lips if you want to. I just don't want to lay out my lips. And then after I wipe my face with the towel, I'm gonna go in and get my ears and all of that. I know I'm not seeing what I am because I'm trying to look up into the camera. I think that's good. When you come in, so you put it in, if you don't have a scrub can, then you need to start by cleaning the scrub. That's good. And what I like to do is, I go under my eye, I go like this, I go in the corner, and then I go on top. Then I hold my finger behind my lashes and hold my face down and just scrub it. And that helps us get all the lint and stuff that touches. So I do sleep the teeth. And then I put my finger under it and just wipe down, do not wipe hard. You should barely feel it. And make sure you get your hairline real good, so when you sleep, you don't have no oil and sugar or anything. This is how it is.
There, I think I got the raise in my eye.
Behind that ear. Okay, so then you're gonna take that oil, you can take vitamin E oil, you can take castor oil. You can do a mixture of honey and stuff, because I do have honey in this as well. Make it your own. Let spirit talk to you. I made this about, this is going on 2 years ago. So back in 2018, I made this oil. Like in October of 2018. And it is currently March of 2020, and I still have it. Like I said in previous videos, I use it on special occasions. And the main part I would like to get is up under here. Because it's going to take away all of my marks. And I like to get up under my eye. It's really good. Even though I don't wear foundation like that and I don't have that dark eye problem, I just love to make sure that my collagen and everything is staying how it's supposed to be. Like, I'm pushing 30. And I still got people asking me, am I my sister's daughter? I look at them like, how old do y'all think I am? Everybody be like, 18. I look like, I'm like, what the heck is wrong with you? Ooh, sorry. Ooh, almost had a Janet Jackson moment. Man, he's gonna kick my ass. But yeah. And then I had to do my tweezing and stuff the other day. I kind of do it daily, depends on, you know, how it comes in. Like right now, I feel like it's like a little tiny hair down here. And if you don't know, Ben came out most comfortable about talking about PCOS and stuff like that. And part of my PCOS problems is I don't have acne, but I do have obsessive hair growth and stuff like that. So I get like a little bit of hair down here and I squeeze. So yeah, I do have some organic deodorant, but it's at the old spot. So I'm just gonna use my secrets over. I was trying to keep it super organic for y'all. And then with these oils, I still might mix some of that tea tree oil in with that, and I will be putting this on my lower parts. So I'm just gonna go in with my secrets. This stuff smells so good, y'all. Like, especially when I go down south, it's like the only deodorant I use, because any other deodorant, I would smell weird. Even my Dove, because y'all know I was a Dove girl. I had every flavor Dove deodorant you could think of, especially when they had like the matching sprays and stuff to the Dove and the Secret thing back at Family Dollar a while ago, for a couple years back. I don't know if they sell it like that anymore. So yes, I'm gonna go ahead and lotion up, you guys. I'll probably prep some more stuff tonight and finish vlogging tonight, and then the other half of my beauty prep vlog, I'm gonna vlog tomorrow. So, you guys, two of the other products I got, I'm sorry, keep walking on. I did end up getting the kit, because I was like, if I can't do my hair, at least I can try to practice to do this. That's why I didn't do this before pampering, that way I didn't turn my nails orange or anything. And then also, I ended up getting some more of the primer, so when I start doing eyeshadow again, I can set and set my eyebrows. Catch y'all tomorrow. Ciao. Melanin Nation, Melanin Gang, Melanin Poppin', Melanin Taking Over the World. Period.